गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू अवर ऑनलाइन फिजिक्स क्लासेस। क्लास एट टॉपिक इलेक्ट्रिकल कंडक्टिविटी ऑफ लिक्विड। स्टूडेंट, इन द प्रीवियस क्लासेस वी हैव लर्नड अबाउट द टेस्टिंग द इलेक्ट्रिकल कंडक्टिविटी ऑफ मटेरियल्स। टेस्टिंग द इलेक्ट्रिकल कंडक्टिविटी ऑफ मटेरियल्स From this activity, we observed that some metals allow electric current to pass through them. We call them as good conductors of electricity. From this activity, we observed that some metals allow electric current to pass through them. We call them as good conductors of electricity. We know all metals are good conductors of electricity. All metals are good conductors of electricity. At the same time, the metals that do not allow current to pass through them are called bad conductors of electricity. The materials that do not allow current to pass through them are called bad conductors of materials. From this activity, materials are classified into two types. First one is a good conductor and the second one is a bad conductor. Good conductors means metals that allow the electricity that pass through them. Example for the good conductors is iron nail, safety pin, pencil graphite, etc. Bad conductors means the metals do not allow the electricity that pass through them. Example for the bad conductors are eraser, piece of paper, piece of plastic, piece of chalk, wood, etc. These are the bad conductors. And then we completed the another topic is testing the electrical conductivity of liquids. Testing the electrical conductivity of liquids. Here also we observed some materials only to allow the electricity that pass through them. That means some liquids to allow the electricity that pass through them. These are called as good conductors. And some liquids do not allow the electricity that pass through them are called as bad conductors. Here also, based on this activity, liquids also classified into two types. First one is a good conductor, second one is a bad conductor. Good conductors means the liquids to allow the electricity that pass through them are called as good conductors. Bad conductors, the liquids do not allow the electricity that pass through them are called as bad conductor. Example for the good conductors: drinking water, lemon juice, vinegar, etc. Bad conductors of liquids: distilled water, coconut oil, kerosene, sugar solution, vegetable oil, etc. These are the example for the good conductors and bad conductors. After then, today we are going to learning about why doesn't the LED glow in all the cases. Today we are going to learn why doesn't the LED glow in all the cases. From activity 1 and activity 2. From activity 1 and activity 2. From activity 1, we saw that when current flows through the object inserted in the gap, the bulb glows. Inserted in the gap, the bulb glows. Similarly, in activity 2, we can see that when the liquids between the two pins of the tester allow electrical current to pass through, the circuit is completed. A circuit is completed means circuit is closed and the LED glows. Then we say the liquid is a good conductor. Here, carefully observed from activity 1 and activity 2. From activity 1, we can be see that current flows through the object inserted in the gap. Inserted in the gap. Then the bulb glow. Then the bulb glow. Similarly, from activity 2, we can see that when the liquids between the two pins of the tester, liquids between the two pins of the testers allow electric current to pass through, the circuit is completed and the LED glow, then we say the liquid is a good conductor. And next one is, when the liquids does not allow electric current to pass through, the circuit is incomplete. Circuit is incomplete means circuit is open and the LED does not glow. Then we see the liquid is a bad conductor. The liquid is a bad conductor. In these two reasons, the LED doesn't glow in all the cases. The LED can glow only in the case of good conductors. In the case of good conductors and the circuit is closed. In the case of good conductors and the circuit is completed. In this cases only the LED can glow. The remaining cases the LED doesn't glow. Next one topic is, from this activity we observed all those cases where the LED glows, its brightness is not same. We see activity 1 and activity 2, the LED glows is not same for all cases. The LED brightness is different for different materials and different liquids. So what is the reason the brightness is not same for all the cases? Here the brightness of the LED depends on the flow of current that pass through the circuit. That means the intensity of the glow of the LED depends on the flow of electrical current that pass through the circuit. So this is the very very important. And next one, why do we use LED in the tester instead of a bulb? So maximum electrical appliances like mobile phone, television, transformer, we use LED in the tester that instead of a bulb, because of LED glows even when a very weak current is passing through the circuit. That is the first one reason. LED glows even when a very weak current is passing through the circuit. And second one is, the LED bulb can be test the flow of electricity in the conductor when meager current is passing through the circuit. Here meager means very very less, very very low current that pass through the circuit. Then the LED will be indicated. LED bulb is indicator in all electrical appliances. All electrical appliances. So these are the main two reasons about the LED is used a tester instead of a bulb. Here also we observed LED have the two leads. One is the shorter lead and the second one is the longer lead. The longer leads always connected a positive terminal of the circuit. The positive terminal of the circuit. and the third lead is connected to the negative terminal of the circuit. Negative terminal of the circuit. So this is the topic on this why do we use LED in the tester instead of a bulb. So thank you.